Hey sir, how's it going?
Good, great. How are you?
Pretty good. So I'm curious about your sign. We've been trying to get some information from you. We can't reach out to you.
You can't? I've been into the several times and they won't interview me.
That's unfortunate. Well, here I am.
Okay.
Name's Jason. So what's up with the sign?
Would you like to get in?
No, I'm not getting your car.
Okay.
Sorry about that.
Okay. There's the truth about the rainbow, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. And it's True Sign Ministries is the name of the corporation that I'm the CEO of.
CEO of, okay.
Yeah, okay.
So are you what's your title as a CEO?
I'm the president of it.
President?
There's two other directors. We've got three directors of the corporation.
What are their names?
What are their names?
Yeah.
One is the pastor of the church I go to, Robert Conrad.
The other one is
Richard Albert.
Richard Albin?
Albert.
Albert,
yeah.
Cool. So they approve of the sign. They're cool with this.
They're completely,
they support it.
They support it, yes. Otherwise,
wow,
they wouldn't have signed on as directors of the company.
I guess that's very true.
Yeah.
So what is your outcome for having the sign drive around the city?
What is my outcome?
Yeah, like what is
I'm
your
outcome? I'm trying to tell people the truth.
And the truth is?
The truth is God's word. And that's all God's word on the sign. There are quotes from the Bible, from Proverbs, a lot of them. And this sign here is a quote from Isaiah. And that one's from Romans. So
okay,
these signs are all Bible. They're all quotations. They're words of God, basically. You know, we're holding up traffic here.
Oh, that's fine. I think they're okay with it.
Yeah. okay. Well, I.
Well, unfortunately, a lot of us don't agree with what you're doing. So
I know yeah, there's a lot of people that don't agree with it, but the media is promoting it. So you know.
I doubt the media is promoting it, but.
Oh, they are. They are. Trust me.
Super unfortunate.
The media. Is totally biased for gay rights. They publish very little against gay rights. So, you know.
And that's probably a good thing, I would assume.
No, I don't agree with that. If you're going to give a balanced report, you gotta publish both sides.
There's a lot of hatred going around.
There's a lot of hatred. I don't hate anybody. Okay.
But your signs say otherwise.
No, God hates pride. God hates the sin of pride, okay?
But
God doesn't hate anybody.
But
God,
being prideful is not
right,
wrong.
Right there, God, yes it is.
Being Why prideful. Is it being because happy for yourself
God,
wrong?
God doesn't say anything good about pride in the Bible. It's all negative. Everything's negative about pride. I don't know why they chose...
So what word would you have chosen?
What?
What word have you have chosen to make it better?
It's a sin.
To be prideful.
Prideful is a sin.
It's a prideful, okay.
Yeah, okay, it's a sin. It's a sin, and very clear. God says it's a sin.
See, we didn't hold any traffic. We're fine.
Yeah, okay, no problem. No problem. What was your name again?
Jason Todd,
okay. In fact, there was another guy I wanted to contact, basically, because I got another story dealing with Revenue Canada. And it could be a story that affects a lot of seniors, basically.
If that's your God and your belief, you're a f***ing joke. You're a f***ing joke. You're f***ing disgusting, man. There's a special spot in big gay hell for you, you f***ing hater.
So you must get that a lot.
Oh, I get that a lot.
And how do you feel about all that?
Hey, they crucified the Lord Jesus Christ, didn't they? They hung him on a cross, you know? He was spit on, and he's the savior of the world, you know. He's the one that can give you eternal life if you want it, you know. All you have to do is accept his payment for your sins, and you can live forever in heaven. Simple as that.
Simple as that.
Yeah, it's very simple.
Just hate everyone while you're alive.
No, I don't. I told you, I don't hate anybody, okay? I'm just telling people the truth, okay? I'm telling people what God hates, okay?
And but if you God read, doesn't
if
hate
you read, Yes, he does. Read Proverbs chapter 6.
Okay.
Go, when you go home, read Proverbs chapter 6.
Sure, I'll do that, no problem.
There's seven things in Proverbs chapter 6 that says God hates, okay? Okay? And one of them he calls an abomination, which he's got an extreme hatred for. And that's what he's got an extreme hatred for. He calls homosexuality an abomination as well, which is an extreme hatred for. Okay? Pardon?
Yes, but there's so many other things in the Bible that go against what you do for your everyday living.
Oh, I know that. I know
and so
that.
You're an abomination
that's
as well.
That's why the Bible says, so for then, all have sinned. I've sinned. I'm a sinner.
Yeah.
Okay? But I'm a redeemed sinner, okay? Because I've trusted Jesus Christ to pay for my sins, okay?
So these, why can't these, people who are of
because
they're
walking
gay
down,
community
they're walking be the same. Down street, okay? They're walking down the street because The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things pass away. Behold, all things become new. That happened in my life when I was about 27 years old. That's when I trusted the Lord Jesus Christ. Then things changed in my life, and I started saying, looking at my sinful lifestyle and said, I don't want to live this way anymore. Okay? And that's what they have to do. And nobody's telling them that. Everybody's telling them it's all right to live that way, and it's not all right to live that way. Okay? Homosexuality is a sin against God. It's not against me. It's against God. Okay? And it's against our society. There's no reproduction in homosexuality. Okay? You can't have children. The homosexual relationship cannot reproduce. Okay? And that's why God is against it.
So against all the sciences that procreate without a husband, right?
Pardon?
So against all the science about procreation against not having a husband?
Well, artificial insemination.
You're against that as well?
I haven't researched it biblically, okay? So I can't say.
But that's not a man and a woman reproducing.
What?
That's not a man and a woman reproducing.
It is. In essence, yes, it is. It's somebody's sperm that they took from somebody and artificial inseminating in a woman. It's the same thing. It takes a man and a woman. It doesn't take two men or two women, okay?
You can have two women and both have an artificial insemination and have a child.
Yeah, but you still have to have the man.
The man is there. You just said it. You just admitted it.
Yeah. Well, let's see. Just a second. Hold on. Oh, slide. Hello. Yeah, that's me.
Oh man. did you do that when you lived in Montreal?
Did I do it in Montreal?
Fred Phelps, you know?
No, I didn't do it in Montreal. That's a guy I used to work with at the sugar refinery here in St. John. I worked at the sugar refinery here in St. John for 21 years.
Right.
I transferred to Montreal. I lived up there for 14 years, worked at the sugar refinery in Montreal for 14 years.
Did you drive around with the same signs?
No, I didn't have the idea or the inclination to drive with signs. Hello. Hello, Paul.
You hung up.
No, I didn't hang up.
You know what? Good conversation. Thank you.